We are from the Soft Robotics Lab at ETH Zurich, and we present Getting the Ball Rolling, learning a dexterous policy for a biomimetic tendon-driven hand with rolling contact joints. As our robots get more complex and human-like, we also need to control them to produce human-like behavior. Recent advances in parallelized simulation and reinforcement learning let us train dexterous policies for these biomimetic robots. Here are the main contributions of this work. We present the 5-hand, which is an anthropomorphic robotic hand developed at the Soft Robotics Lab. We show a method to integrate rolling contact joints of the 5-hand into the Mojoko and Isaac Gym simulators to enable reinforcement learning. Finally, we demonstrate that we can learn a closed-loop policy that can be run on a real dexterous robotic hand. The 5-hand is a biomimetic robotic hand designed for researching dexterous manipulation. It has 11 degrees of freedom, replicating many of the joints seen in the human hand. The 5-hand is tendon-driven, being actuated by 16 dynamic steel servo motors located at the wrist. The distal joints of each finger are coupled, and thus there are 16 joints in total for 11 degrees of freedom. This prototype of the hand does not contain joint angle encoders. Instead, the joint angles are estimated from the tendon length using an extended Kalman filter. However, its accuracy decreases in certain cases, such as when there is contact and the tendons are stretched.
We have already shown that we can model the rolling contact joints of these tendons. So, how do we use these models to learn how to control this hand? This is our RL pipeline. We simulate multiple robot hands in a GPU-based simulator to train a policy with the PPO algorithm. It uses an asymmetric actor-critic framework so that the actor works with only physically measurable observations. Then, we export the trained policy to the real robot and run it in a closed-loop manner. This is the policy training visualized in Isaac Gym. We simulate 4,096 hands in parallel for about an hour to obtain a policy that can be directly applied to the real robot. To transfer our policy seamlessly to the real world, we domain randomize several factors, such as the size and density of the ball and friction coefficients. With sufficient randomization, the trained controllers were able to rotate the sphere in both directions, while policies without randomization failed. Thank you for watching.